They don't shoot them.
Nope. It's a brand new iPhone. Midland Champ, how would you kind of assess the weekend?
Yeah, you know, good weekend. Always a good week when you come home winning a tournament like this. You know, competition was tough, and lucky enough to come out with a first-place finish.
Where does this rank? I mean, you've had some big wins, some big tournament titles and stuff in the past. Where does this rank as far as accomplishments go?
You know, confidence-wise, you know, this doesn't shake my confidence at all. You know, like, it's hard. We talk about, like, happy. Can your confidence really be that weak when something this small affects it? You know, confidence is something that comes from in here. But, you know, it's an awesome tournament. You know, growing up, you watch this tournament. You know, you're like, oh, Brett Metcalf won this tournament. You know, Doug Moses, whoever it is, like, you hear all these years. So it's cool to be part of a little bit of history, be able to wrestle in this prestigious tournament, you know.
Going through Vegas, now Midlands. I know you guys have had a couple of duels, too. Mm-hmm. Seems like 184 is almost seems like a natural progression for you. Seems like you've adjusted pretty easily.
Yeah, I think so. You know, this summer was awesome. You know, focusing on getting bigger, getting better at wrestling, falling back in love with the sport, you know, it was awesome. And I think at 174, I wouldn't be able to do that.
Were there any adjustments bumping up? I know it's only 10 pounds, but...
You know, there was the weight room, the discipline of it, you know, the dieting and everything. Like, it was something different, you know, because I usually don't diet much. So getting X amount of meals in a day, working out, getting calories, like, it was a nice, different adjustment. And there's new guys at the weight, too, you know. Been wrestling the same guys for 3 years now, so it's a nice change.
Team as a whole, I think you guys are locked into second.
Yeah.
Second big tournament that you guys have been through. Where do you like where they're at right now?
As a team?
Yeah.
We're in a great place, you know. We got a killer heavyweight. We got a killer 74-pounder. I mean, everyone's dynamite. You know, Max Thompson, Paige Moore, Jace Warm, Jacob Horst. Like, we're ready to roll, you know. And this is all preparation for March. I just tell them, joke, but it's all preparation for March, you know. Win or lose, it's getting ready for Nationals, you know. Could have went 0-2 here, but there's still something to take away from it to get ready for March. And that's personally my main goal.
Doug was talking about how you guys will be battle-tested. I mean, obviously, these are between Vegas and here, two different fields, but two different tough fields. Do you feel like this is things you guys can use moving forward?
Yeah, for sure. You know, like, you getting your warm-up down, your diet, resting between matches, knowing how your body works, and sticking to your routine. That Doug talked about. Stick to your routine. So it just solidifies that you're doing the right things, you know. And when you have a good outcome like that, it just shows you're doing the right things.
How much scouting did you do on the side today?
What'd you say?
How much scouting did you do before the match tonight?
I didn't know who he was. I know he wrestled with one of our guys at the Grandview Open. That's about it. I don't know. I know he's a young guy. You know, I'm a little older than
him. I just wondering.
Yeah.
Do you have actual bones in your knees? Or does that work?
Dude, I'm
in
just,
that first period, I thought your leg was just broken.
Oh, and I limp. Oh, yeah. I'm telling you, I think when I hit 26, it's going to be replaced. But I don't know, I'm pretty lucky. I have very flexible hips and knees, and
that's
I'm just waiting. Sure. I'm just waiting.
Thanks.
But thank you.